Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel, and Joe's behind the camera, and we are two krazy ketos, and we're here today at the Las Vegas Keto Expo with none other than Nicole Burgess.
Hey, guys.
You need to be following her every single day. You were an amazing speaker yesterday.
Oh, I was so nervous. I was so nervous.
You nailed it.
Oh, thank you.
And, okay, so you're one of those speakers that there's, like, the excuses are just worked out.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
You challenged us.
There's no excuse.
Because you could have totally, like, you have such an inspirational story. You talked about motivation. You could have mic dropped right there. It was amazing.
Yeah.
But you didn't end on you need motivation to be successful. You need determination. So I wondered if you could share a little bit about that, because my thing is, well, if I feel like going to the gym, or I feel like getting in my fitness, or if I feel like staying on track and I feel really motivated and I've seen enough like pretty pictures, then I do it. But sometimes you just have to do it. Yeah. Even if you don't want
to. Just grind it out. I mean, there were some times where the kids had to go to school, so there was no option for me to be able to go to the gym later, because I'll be honest, the 4 a.m. workouts suck.
Okay? Yeah.
But I was like, this is my goal. Like, I want to be able to go to the gym. This is my ambition. So this is the only time I have. You know, because a lot of people always, they tell me, I don't have time. And I always say, you've got to make the time. There's always time. It's just a matter of if you want it bad enough.
Yeah.
So if you want it bad enough, you're going to get up at 4 o'clock and go to the gym. Is it going to suck? Yeah. But.
Because I say to myself in the moment, like, oh, I want these things. And it's like, I think sometimes we get motivated, but it's still in like the wish category.
Oh, yeah.
And unless you get it up. And when you were saying like day after day that you were just doing it, and it's like, you had small children, you're running a house, you got
mom,
a job,
wife, life, you know.
Teacher. I mean, when you were talking about doing this and starting this, the first year of teaching, no one realizes because my family are all teachers and they know, like, especially that first year.
The first couple of years are rough.
It's not like it's rough. Everybody's, hey, we're your committee that's going to help you set up your room. And like, it's no, that's not.
Nobody's helping you at all.
So it's like you had every excuse.
Every excuse in the beginning,
to not follow through. What continues to keep you determined?
Well, just being healthy overall, I think, is the main drive. And I do have two kids, you know, so it's, everybody's like, oh, you're just doing it for the body aspect and this. I'm like, that's
which is
not,
amazing, P.S.
Like, that's not my goal, you know, is that's not my first initial goal. Is I have two kids and two boys, especially, y'all know.
Oh, yeah.
And running after them is tiring. And when you're 230 pounds, it's even more tiring.
It is.
You know, so just to be able to be here as long as I can for them is my number one priority.
I love that.
They're always my drive. But I always say, too, if it wasn't for YouTube and if it wasn't for all the followers, would I still be doing this? I don't know. You know, I always say all the time, I'm like, they're always like, you're so motivating. You know, you get me to the gym every week. I'm like, you guys get me to the gym
every week. That's what we keep saying. We keep telling everybody, you don't understand. You motivate us more than we motivate
it's
you.
It's that built-in accountability.
Exactly. Yeah, and I think about it, I'm like, man, I'm really tired this morning. I'm just going to make today a rest day. And I'm like, no, people are counting on you to post on Instagram, so just go. You know, like,
and it's, get it over with. And again, I mean, the coaching side is just so amazing. And you are just a natural coach, because you're also coaching us on what we can eat and meal planning. And really what drew me to you immediately was your meal prepping for the week and all of the that you provide, because you don't make it boring. I mean, you're going on a camping trip and I'm watching you and I'm writing down everything that we can take for a camping trip, because you still make it fun. So what does your thought process go like when you are planning ahead for a week?
I plan weeks ahead. People think I'm nuts because in my car manager, I have stuff planned in right now until November.
Wow. But that is so awesome.
You know, well, and I like to switch it up too, you know, and I say it all the time, like, I really am boring and basic. Like, I could eat the same breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day because I know it works for me. I know it keeps me on plan, but I know people like variety. I was like, so you guys are also pushing me to go out my comfort zone too and trying different things. So I do it for the variety for everybody else too, but it helps keep you accountable. If you plug things in ahead of time, or if you have a plan on what you know you need to eat, you're more likely to stay on track and not go off.
So true. And you don't know what a day is going to bring.
No.
Yeah, I mean, especially like as a mom, like forget it.
We just had Ida come through.
Oh my gosh.
And we had no power for 19 days. You know, no grocery store access, nothing. And I had those 2 weeks planned in my car manager, and I was able, I had to walk to the road to get any service. I'm like, what am I eating? Plugging it in, use the Blackstone, and you know, cranked it out.
But you were prepared for
it. I was prepared.
And it also speaks into like the stress eating. If you're somebody like us that like stress eats, that's the best thing that you can do is meal prep. So you're not taking, you know, like we had a stressful week last week, and I thought, man, if we didn't have a plan on what we were eating, this is the day where I would have cleaned out the fridge for us.
Yeah.
Like just eating it all. So we're going into the holidays. Maybe a lot of times, because you said this, and I was laughing so hard when you're like, when did my gym day start? Yeah. January 1st or January 2nd, because that's when we start to get a case of do better. But
new year, new me.
Why can we get started in the holiday season?
You can start today, you know, and like I'm doing a challenge right now called Fall for Gains, and I did it specifically like through the first week of November for everybody because people love a challenge. It helps them keep accountable too. And I'm like, why are we just talking about, you know, summer shredded bodies, you know, like new year, new me. I'm like, we can still stay healthy all year round. Like that should be the goal, is to stay healthy all year, not just for a season, get off and get back on and just keep yo-yoing. You know, we need to continue to be healthy all year long. And people always like, well, I'll start next month. I'll start the second. Start today. Like, what's holding you back? You might not be here tomorrow. So
that is so true. Now, what do you find is like the biggest frustration that you're finding people bump into as newbies in, you know, entering the space?
I like I said when I spoke yesterday, motivation. That's the main thing people say, I'm not motivated, or how do you stay so positive? How do you stay motivated? And that's when I'm like, look, motivation's great, but you can't rely on it for everything. Like you just, if you want something bad enough, you gotta find your why. You have to find something that's going to drive you internally instead of looking for those external motivations everywhere. Yeah, you just have to. And if you're not there yet, you're not ready yet.
So what is next for Nicole Burgess?
I'm just grinding right now as far as like my strength training journey right now is where I'm at. That's another thing too. A lot of
What is your goal for that? Are you going to start doing like some
Everybody keeps saying like Sandra over there, she's going to be competing next year and I'm so proud of her. And she's like, you've got to compete. And I'm like, I never would have dreamed. Like people ask me that before and I'm like, no, you know, I'm a mom. I can't do that. You know, and now I'm like,
a hot mom.
I'm like, it might be possible, you know? So I think I got a year of work to do, and then that might be in the cards. I don't know.
That is the coolest thing. So now if somebody is looking for private coaching, you do offer that.
I do coaching. So I do actually additional services if people just want macros or if they want Zoom consultations, and that has been like a really hot ticket right now. I think a lot of people, I'm happy to see it though, because a lot of people fall off right now, and that like we're talking about for this time of year. But a lot of people are like, you know, screw it. I'm getting healthy right now. I'm not waiting for the new year, new me.
So good.
So that's really good. But I have one-on-one coaches. So I do their customized meal plans. Like they send me screenshots of their fridges. I mean, it's very custom. And we do Zoom meetings and text messages. And it's just so fun to be able to be a part of journey with everybody on YouTube. And then to be able to be so one-on-one as well with clients. It's super fun. And
so how should they reach out to you?
On my website, NicoleBurgess.net. So, and they can find me on YouTube and Instagram.
Well, I get like before we ended here, I just have to say, you have been so motivating to me to continue like growing out my hair.
You motivated me.
I feel like we're silver sisters.
Yes, we are. Look, I watched your video and your whole like documentation, and
is it freeing?
You helped me like not feel insecure about it, or like jump the bullet and just do it, because I'd always thought about it.
Gorgeous.
Thanks. You do too.
And we talk about motivation now. Our subscribers motivated her.
Yes, because you do, especially if you're like, well, if people are going to see me and I'm on a video or something, I can't be like growing out this.
Yeah, that's what
like,
I said
hair.
Too. And I was like, you know what? Rachel's doing it. I'm doing it too.
I'm so glad. But
and
like,
look, a year next month, a year. That's where we are.
Absolutely
so,
gorgeous.
Yours is too.
But isn't it interesting?
It feels so good.
It does. And it's like, it's one less thing you have to think about because you don't have to be constantly like checking for growth. It's actually like when my roots are growing out, it's actually blessing what I'm trying to accomplish.
Your hair's so much healthier.
Doesn't it? But isn't it interesting how everybody has a different pattern? So in your mind, you're thinking, I'm gonna be Linda Evans from Dynasty or something. And it's like, that may not be how your hair grows because it's not just a one-dimensional
and when
color.
It's, when it's first growing out and it's against your, you know, dyed color, it's very drastic, the difference. So you have a whole perception of what you think it's gonna look like, but when it starts coming out, you're like, wow, I really like it.
It's so freaking cool. So I don't know. I'm just excited.
Well, thank you, because like I said, you were my motivation to buy bite the bullet for sure.
Well, thanks so much for being in this space and just encouraging us all. And you got to check her out. If you are not watching her, get right. So guys, that's going to be our video for today. If you like videos like this, you want to check out over here, or if you'd like to check out our most recent video, you can find it over here. But whether you go this way or you go this way, don't forget to go this way. Subscribe to our channel and click the little bell icon, and that way every single time we get to talk to Nicole Burgess, you'll be alerted to it. Until next time, bye guys.